We are rolling.
I think in the past year, the most exciting innovation I've seen in AI is probably, you know, what's really mainstream around ChatGPT and things like Copilots coming out that take that ChatGPT and put it in context with the user so that it's a little easier for them to understand and implement. And probably on the coding side, you know, being able to do the same thing with software development, right? So now an engineer that maybe wasn't as fast as their peer is now able to keep up and keep pace because they can use the AI to help them code hard problems that they would, you know, normally take days to solve. So I think the next phase of digital transformation is going to be shaped by a few different trends in AI, and I think one of them is probably disruption in the RPA space, the robotic process automation. I think you're going to see that completely overhauled, where an agent is trained to do a specific portion of the task and then it passes it off to another disciplined agent, right? And that's going to be fairly easy to create. I think some of the other trends are probably what I highlighted in the last question, which is just the adoption of accelerated coding through the tooling. So, you know, the ability to go through. In the past, we wouldn't have gone through an enterprise system and rewritten the code base because it's just too expensive to do that. So we'd level up pieces of it over the years, but you still have an aging estate. And so I think the ability to actually rewrite those applications completely using AI for probably 80% of the workload is going to accelerate that work and movement. So a lot more companies are going to get through their digital transformation faster. To incorporate GenAI in your tech stack, I think you need to start with policy. Like when the internet came around, we didn't just go out and start using it. We put policies in place as CTOs for our companies to ensure that users were safe with what they were doing and that they were understood the risk in using the technology. So I think that's step one. Step two then is really, you know, find the vein of that technology that you're seeing even in public markets on things like Instagram and Facebook where people are leveraging the technology, and think about ways you can apply that in your own business. So, you know, example of that might be writing better job descriptions using ChatGPT, right? Or writing better marketing copy for your marketing team. But, you know, don't think that that's going to completely disrupt how you do things. It's really just additive and it's going to optimize the workforce for you. Yeah, I use GenAI probably daily now in my workflow, and it adds a lot of value. So I think about like the presentation I just gave this week on stage. The first thing I did was ask GenAI what should be in that content, right? Given this title and abstract, what content or outline should I expect? And then I went through that and built my content and used it to help me build the content. I also used it to generate all my images, so I don't have to search through image libraries and try and find that image that portrays what I'm trying to do within, you know, 2 minutes. I have an image that's generated through an online service using the AI, and then I play around with a few different ones and put it into my presentation. So it really accelerates that cycle of development. How do you future-proof your AI strategy to stay competitive in the long term? I think about it like software engineering or software development. You know, with the data center, I think we were better at building processes to keep that technology updated because there was usually a vendor relationship, and if you fell too far behind, you had no support, so it put a lot of risk on the business. We didn't do the same thing in our software development, right? We have legacy code that's been 30 years old sitting there, and we call that technical debt. So I think just a constant practice of updating your estate or remodeling your home, right, to make sure that you're using the latest and greatest is going to help you stay on the forefront of AI, and it's going to build a continuous, you know, improvement process within your company to stay on the edge. So best practices for data privacy and security in AI is going to be, first off, controlling access to the data. Like, what level of granularity should the user have? You know, do you want your legal team pushing, you know, your patient data up into an AI service? Probably not, right? So building that governance model around who should be able to access what level of data, and then what data can be exposed publicly versus what needs to stay private and sensitive. You know, unfortunately, there's not a lot of solutions in the market yet to help solve this. You know, DLP attempts to do it, but doesn't really know where the data's going, and so it can't really solve the problem. We've seen some new startups creating technology, though, that works similar to an API gateway that will intercept that request and look at the data and say, okay, there's PII in here, and actually pull that back or obfuscate that data before it goes out, you know, keeping you in compliance and de-risking, you know, the company.